Hello, friends. We all dream about the future and who we will be in a few years from now. Yet we postpone everything that we could do today for later, and we think that our whole life is still ahead of us. We don't prioritize living. We skip on taking our time to enjoy each new day and avoid loving and spending time with the people closest to us. In the end, realizing that we're wasting life on things that aren't important to us at all. It's only when it's too late that we realize how much time has been wasted, and we begin to appreciate each day that passes. There's no such thing as too much time, and Lila Mae's story will serve as proof of that. Unfortunately, her story doesn't have a happy ending. My heart is shattered into a million pieces were the exact teary-eyed words of Lila's mother, Heidi Hall, who wrote on her Facebook page dedicated to her little girl, "There is no pain on earth that is worse than this. The world will never be the same without her beautiful face here with us." The little girl from Oregon was supposed to have her whole life ahead of her, but at the age of 2, she was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. For several years, the little girl had fought this terrible disease like a true warrior, and there was still a slim chance. But just before her daughter's 5th birthday, Lila's parents learned that this would be her last big celebration. One more round of chemotherapy was just too much for the exhausted baby's body to handle. When the doctors told her mother that Lila's body was too weak to continue treatment, her family and their huge community came together as one to bring her as much joy as they could for the time she had left. When her mother asked the little girl shortly before her birthday what her dream was, Lila replied that she wanted to experience and feel everything that time would take away from her. The mother and father, Heidi Hall and Ryan Shaw, made a willful decision for themselves. They tried to put many of the moments she would have experienced in the future into this final celebration. A huge number of strangers got involved and helped with the organization. That day, July 31st, their princess arrived at a real ball. The little girl was dressed in a fairy tale dress and a beautiful tiara, and among the guests were mermaids, princesses, and superheroes. The carriage brought Lila to a castle style built in the center of her hometown, and many people gathered in the square in front of it. Hundreds of unfamiliar men and women, adults, and children came to support her. They were all willing to do anything for the smile on the face of a little person, even if she was a complete stranger. Once inside the building, she found herself in the kingdom from Cinderella. Lila loves princesses very much. The little girl couldn't believe that this was actually happening. A graduation ceremony was organized for the girl, seeing as this is a landmark event for students, a ticket to adulthood. And at 5 years old, she was experiencing this very exciting moment, just as she was to experience it after many years, with full seriousness and responsibility. All the invited guests smiled and clapped, and the young girl was over the moon with joy. After that, the next act of celebration was her wedding. Her father, Ryan, got down on one knee and asked her if she was ready to be his one and only in the world. He proposed to her, asking for her hand in marriage, the hand that had been his for a long time now. Lila answered yes with great pleasure, and after these words, all the guests present were overwhelmed with emotion. The father hugged his little girl. He could hardly contain his tears. Ryan danced his first dance with his little treasure, and those moments will forever be remembered by many. Later, Lila said her favorite part was when my daddy cried, even though she didn't know why. It was probably because he was so happy, she added. News of the entire town's generosity and the princess's dream made headlines around the world, drawing attention to the story. Lila still had one more dream, to dance on stage with Luke Bryan, the American country singer and songwriter that the little girl loved so much. Whenever she hears his songs play, she starts dancing, Lila's mother said. If she could be on stage with him while he sings that song, it would be the best gift for her. After reading about the little girl's wish on Facebook, Bryan took the chance to make the little girl's dream come true. Luke personally called the little girl and talked to her on the phone for a full 30 minutes, after which he expressed his support for her parents. They were very impressed with the star's gesture. Bryan also recorded a special message for Lila, saying that she and her family would receive VIP tickets to the upcoming concert. He was going to let Lila sing her favorite song along with him on a huge stage. But unfortunately, the little girl never made it to her idol's concert. Her condition rapidly deteriorated, she was placed in a hospice, and a few days later, she conclusively lost her battle with cancer, devastating the hearts of the inconsolable parents. All of Oregon came to say goodbye to her. Thanks to the support of the community and the residents, Lila's last weeks were filled with moments of true love, genuine emotion, and pure joy, said Lila's father. I'm grateful to everyone for doing this for us. The picture of the fragile little girl, posted later by her mother on Facebook, still inspires thousands of people with the smile on her face. Friends, take care of yourself and your loved ones, and appreciate the time we have.